आसार संसार खलु दुःखस्वरूपी विमुखः सुतः कस्य धनं कस्य स्नेहवान् जलते अनिशं न च इन्द्रस्य सुखं किञ्चिन्न सुखं चक्रवर्तिनः सुखम् अस्ति विरक्तस्य मुनेरेकान्तजीविनः आसार संसार खलु दुःखस्वरूपी विमुखः सुतः कस्य धनं कस्य स्नेहवान् जलते अनिशं न च इन्द्रस्य सुखं किञ्चिन् किञ्चिन्न सुखं चक्रवर्तिनः सुखम् अस्ति विरक्तस्य मुनेरेकान्तजीविनः गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड दैट आचार्य इज द मैसेंजर ऑफ भगवान सुप्रीम लॉर्ड गौड़ीय गोष्ठीपति श्री शिल भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी ठाकुर प्रभुपाद जगद्गुरु टोल्ड that Acharya is the representative, the messenger of Supreme Lord. Actually, Acharya, Sadguru, going to give us the information of Vaikuntha Jagat. They are going to carry all the message of Vaikuntha Jagat. They are going to bring that message to us. Sometimes we become angry. Why Acharya speaking so heavily? But we don't know. Acharya has no responsibility. The message coming from that Vaikuntha Jagat, it is the duty of Acharya to hand over the letter to you. Nothing to do. If there is any good message, for that he is not going to take any donation. If there is any very dangerous message, painful message, still you cannot give punishment to him. All message coming from Vaikuntha Jagat and Vaikuntha messengers, they are going to carry all message for us and they are simply going to deliver it to us. All those messages of Vaikuntha Jagat, Sadguru, going to speak in front of us, Vaikuntha Vani, Chaitanya Vani, Vaikuntha Vani, Golok Vani. Only we will have to hear very carefully with Seva mood. Bhaddaji, due to his tatastha condition, sometime can express desire to enjoy. Bonded soul due to his tatastha position, any time they are in problem. So we will have to hear those Vaikuntha Bani very carefully from Acharya, Guru, Vaishnava with Seva mood. If we can show our 100% surrender unto the lotus feet of Acharya, surely we can get Kripa. There is no shortage of any Kripa. Kripa is there, affluent Kripa. But we cannot catch, we cannot accept. Many devotees used to put question in front of Guru Pad Padma. We are doing so many things. Why we are not getting Kripa? Why we are not going to get Kripa? Due to some aparad, unknown aparad, we don't know when and how we are doing aparad. That aparad going to put us down. We want to enjoy Guru Vishnu. We don't like to serve Guru Vishnu. We have no seva mood. We are staying in front of Guru Vaishnava. We are showing that we are going to do seva. But we have no seva mood. Because actual seva mood is there. Actual seva mood is there. Actual seva mood is there. But still I am not getting kippah. It is impossible. The only reason we don't like to serve, we are staying in front of Guru Vishnu, we are going to show that we are serving Guru Vishnu, but we have some enjoying mood. We like to enjoy the good name of Guru Vishnu. We always want to enjoy. We have some enjoying mood. Serving mood is not there. We like to take advantage of Guru Vaishnava, their power, their kippa. This way we are going to fall down. We cannot get kippa. We like to enjoy Guru Vaishnava. Their name, their affection, their love. All day we like to enjoy. We like to show Guru Seva. We like to take the post of Gurudev. We like to take all properties of Gurudev. We like to take all money, etc. from Gurudev. But we don't know. If one penny, if I am going to enjoy from Guru Vishnu, then when Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj speaking, for infinity period, we have to go down. Very dangerous. Material thieves, material cheaters, someday they can get scope to come out. But those who are going to take Guru Vaishnava property, they cannot get any excuse. Day by day, they can go down and down and down. Nobody can save them. Prabhupada speaking, actually, Vaikuntha Bani, those who are messengers of Vaikuntha, they can speak. Other people cannot speak exactly about Vaikuntha Bani because they have no practical experience. Vaikuntha Parshad, Vaikuntha messengers, they can speak exactly in toto, everything. But common people, ordinary devotees, they can try to speak about Vaikuntha Bani, but they cannot speak. And even if they are speaking, it cannot touch our heart, because it is not direct realization. Without direct realization, if somebody is going to speak, it cannot touch our heart. That's why Prabhupada speaking, except those Vaikuntha messengers, nobody can speak exactly the message of, cannot deliver the message of Vaikuntha. The sloka I started with is very important sloka. If Chaitya Guru going to give kippa to us, if Chaitya Guru going to support us, then one Siddhanta Bani can change our whole life. Suppose same Harikatha, suppose some devotee hearing many times, but only that day when Acharya speaking, that Harikatha going to touch the heart, going to change. That's mean that day Chaitya Guru going to support. By the help of Chaitya Guru, we can understand everything, we can realize. Without the support of Chaitya Guru, we cannot. Guru Kippa, if Guru Kippa is there, then Chaitya Guru can teach us so many things from inside. If full Guru Kippa is there, if I am enjoying full Guru Kippa, then from inside my heart, Chaitya Guru can give me information. So many things. If Chaitya Guru not going to support, then even after hearing Harikatha, I cannot accept. I can express Annavilas, different kind of separate desires, which can throw me into the ocean of miseries. I can speak one example. One very intelligent man, is actually young man, he took decision to go out of home. He liked to go away, but he cannot take final decision. Oscillating condition, his mind sometimes thinking, well, I can go out and take renounce order, and then no, in whom I can say. Someday he reach Varanasi, and at the bank of Ganga he reach, took bath, and at the same time he took information that there is some harikatha. One big sadhu, realized soul, speaking harikatha. After taking bath, he reached there, and the harikatha was about to start, almost. After that, the sadhu started this harikatha. Harikatha, and the first slok, asar sansar khalu dukshrupi bimahak sutah kasya dhanam kasya snehavan jalate anisham na cha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartinah sukham asti viraktasya mune rekant jivinah. One slok, asar sansar khalu असारु संसार खुलु दुःखरूपी बीमा कहा. ओनली वन श्लोक व्हाट भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर राइटिंग इन कीर्तन सेम थिंग इन द भागवत ग्लोरिफिकेशन पद्म पुराण द श्लोक आई स्पीक फास्ट. भक्तिविनोद ठाकुर स्पीकिंग, किशेर संसारे छायाबाजी पाए इहाते ममता करी बिथा दिन जाए. Follow what I say. Bhaktivinoda was speaking. What kind of this sansar? It is just like a, you know, mesmerism, magic. Kise sansari chayabaji pai? Ihate mamata kuri bitha din jai. I am wasting my time. I am growing affinity for sansar. I am growing enjoying mood. Maharaj, Vairagya is such a thing. If someday going to touch your heart, then I need not speak so many katha. Vairagya is such an excellent thing. If someday going to touch your heart, then I need not speak so many katha. Vairagya raga rasiko bhava bhakti nishtho. Gokarna ji Maharaj speaking to his father, Atmadev. He is speaking, you are going attention to affinity to sansar, material improvement. Material enjoyment. But be careful. Sevasya sadhu purushan jahi kama tishna. You'll have to serve pure Guru Vaishnava from heart, not exhibition. There is guarantee in Shastra. If you are going to serve pure Guru Vaishnava from heart, there cannot be any bondage. Soon you can get free. It is the commitment of Bhagavatam. It is written in Bhagavatam. न तथा ही अगवान राजन पुयेत तप आदि जथा कृष्णार्पित प्राण तत्पुरुष निषेवया न तथा ही अगवान दो सिंफुल मैन्स दे कैन नॉट प्यूरिफाई देमसेल्व एनी हाउ दे कैन डू एसटीटी पिनांस सो मेनी थिंग दे कैन बट दे कैन प्यूरिफाई देमसेल्व वेरी वेरी क्विकली by serving pure Guru Vishnu. Yatha Krishnarpita prana tat purusha nisevaya, yatha tat purusha tat purusharpita prana tat, yatha Krishnarpita prana tat purusha nisevaya, na tatha hi agavan, na tatha hi bhagavan, न तथा ही अगवान राजन पुयेत तप आदि हे राजन मैस्ट्रिजी एंड पिनांस सो मेनी यू कैन ट्राई एनी हाउ यू कैन नॉट प्यूरिफाई योर सेल्फ दैट मच प्यूरिफिकेशन यू कैन नॉट गेट न तथा ही अगवान राजन पुयेत तप आदि तपस्या एस्टेड फिनांसेस यथा लाइक एज यू कैन डू बाय सर्विंग कृष्णार्पित प्राण तत्पुरुष निषेवया बाय सर्विंग केयरफुली द प्योर गुरु विष्णु वेयर आर द हार्ट एंड सोल टोटली डेडिकेटेड फॉर द सर्विस ऑफ कृष्ण इफ यू कैन सर्व देम वेरी बट यू आर नॉट गेटिंग व्हाई Because something, some problem is there inside your heart. Some problem is there inside your heart. That's why you are not getting result. You are not getting result. There's some problem. Problem means enjoying mood you have. You cannot serve. You can show you are serving. You cannot serve. You are enjoying mood. Asara saṃsāra khulu dukṣarūpi bhimā kaha All Jivatma in the whole universe, they are running with enjoying mood. All men except Vaishnav, except those, you know, elevated Vaishnav, all Jivatma, ordinary Jivatmas, they are all running with a conception of enjoying mood, with a mood of enjoying, with a desert of enjoying mood. They are running. Asaro saṃsāra khulu dukṣarūpi bhimaka. Only by hearing this slok, only one slok, explanation. Asaro saṃsāra khulu dukṣarūpi bhimaka. This material world is full of pain. No pleasure, only pain and pain. And it is full of, you know, problem. But we are hypnotized, overwhelmed. We get overwhelmed by this, you know, material samsara. After hearing that young man lived samsara forever. After hearing this only one slope, he's going to live samsara forever. He never go back to home. And we are hearing so many Harikatha. We are not developing any detachment. Why? Knowingly, unknowingly some aparad doing. We cannot enjoy Guru Vaishnava. If we like to enjoy Guru Vaishnava, their reputation, their so everything, then we can be in problem. Never we can come out successfully. Yesterday I was speaking about Acharya Aranir Adya Sad Ante Vasi Uttar Arani Tat Sandhyanam Pravachanam Vidya Sandhi Sukhavaha. I was speaking. In Bhagavad-gita Mahapuran, 11th canto, Bhagavan Sri Krishna giving advice to Uddhavji Maharaj, there Krishna speaking, Acharya Aranir Adya, like two dry wooden piece going to we are going to make friction, we are going to make with each other. Down, Acharya Aroninado, the main wooden piece is Acharya, and the small one, this is Shisha, disciple. Acharya Aroninado, Acharya Aroninado, Sad Ante Vasi Uttararani. And this way, if you go on doing friction, very, very dry wood, inside there wood, there is a possibility, potency of fire. And fire can come out. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Acharya going to speak in front of Shishya, disciple, with full acharan, efficacy. Also, if you like to digest all Harikatha, you will have to follow all etiquette acharan, perfect. Those who are following perfect acharan, Vaishnava etiquette, full, you have to know very carefully what all are the etiquettes. Then you can digest Harikatha. Otherwise, you can hear. This Harikatha cannot stand inside your heart. Like Judy, like, you know, Andho Dhritarashtra speaking. Andho Dhritarashtra speaking to Vidurji Maharaj. Vidurji is the mantri, minister, giving so many advice. Very, very nice, nice advice. Andho Dhritarashtra speaking, I know you are speaking all right. It is dharma, very perfect thing you are speaking. But what to do? I am very weak. I cannot catch your point. I cannot digest, I cannot accept. I know it is wrong, but still I like to do it. So weak person, those who are chitbal, those who are not going to collect enough chitbal for them, it is really difficult to digest all Harikatha. They can misunderstand, they can misinterpret. So Acharya Aroninado, Krishna speaking, Acharya can speak powerful Harikatha in front of those followers. And that Harikatha can set fire. And that Harikatha can set fire inside the heart of those who are hearing. I mean disciple, followers. Tat sandhanam, pravachanam. Pravachan, Harikatha. Vidya Sandhi Sukhava. Suddenly, like one spark of fire, if going to touch some inflammable object, immediately there's a big havoc fire can take place. I already told many times. Chidatma is Chinmoy, Ganomoy, only knowledge is there. Vidya, Avidya, both, Bhagavan speaking, Vidya, Avidya, both there. Inside the heart of Jivatma, for infinity pure. When Vidya is there, then Avidya can get defeated, Avidya cannot stand. Maya, Vairagya Vidya. If someday Vairagya going to touch your heart, then you can understand what I am speaking. You can realize then, not today. Vairagya Raga Rasiko Bhava Bhakti Nishto Sevasya Sadhu Purushan Jahi Kama Tishnam. Follow. Vairagya Raga Rasiko. Vairagya is the Ras. Radharani is topmost Vairagya. Such Vairagya in infinity world, not possible. Even inside Krishna, that kind of Vairagya not possible. You cannot understand. Topmost Vairagya is there inside Radharani. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. You cannot understand. Vairagya is Ross. But you think, I am not habituated to lead my life this way. What do you mean? What do you mean? Now you are Vaishnava. Forget about past. You have no right to speak that way. You are not Vaishnava. Come on. You are hearing Harikatha. Serving Guru Vaishnava. How you can say I am not habituated? I cannot speak like that. Acharya Arani Raddo Swad Ante Vasi Uttararani Tatsandhyanam Pravachanam Vidya Sandhi Sukhabha. Very important thing. Guru Vaishnav, pure Guru Vaishnav like to guide us properly. They like to get control over our fanciful attitude, but we feel disgusted. We feel problem. What to speak? Yesterday I was thinking, I was speaking about how to avoid material enjoyment. If you try your best to avoid enjoying mood, you cannot do. No bonded soul can come out successful by their personal effort. Only by the mercy of Guru Vishnu, Maya re koriya joy charano na jaye, Maya re koriya joy charano na jaye, Sadhu Guru kipa bina na dekhi upay. Without the mercy of Sadhu Guru Vishnu, we cannot cut Maya. We cannot go out of Maya. Impossible. Yesterday I was giving some argument how different political leaders, spiritual leaders, they are going to misguide you. Totally. Yesterday from 6th canto, once first chapter I was speaking, Nasnataha Pattham Mevanyam Vyadhayo Abhibhavantihi Evam Niyamakrit Rajan Sanair Khemayo Kalpati. Anybody who is taking very nice Shuddha Sattvic diet, very pure, his diet is very pure. Everything given in Gita also, Sattvic Ahar, Rajasic Ahar, Tamasic Ahar. Bhagavan Sri Krishna explaining in Gita. How you can understand this is Sattvic Ahar? Of course we are busy with Prasadam. We are less interested about Sattvic Ahar, Rajasic Ahar. Still, in Gita Bhagavan speaking, Sattvic Ahar can make you free of any disease. Sattvic Ahar. Rajasic Ahar, Tamasic Ahar. Everything, Krishna speaking. Anybody who is taking very nice Shuddha Sattvic, very soft and very nice, you know, easy digestible food diet, he is surely, you know, he cannot grow any illness in his body. Less possibility. At the same time, all previous disease can also go away. If he is going to follow rules and regulation, very perfect. Early in the morning, 3 o'clock, get up, take bath, do anik, acharan, everything, and you show me you are sick. You are not doing. You have to follow. Same way, who is following our strict rules and regulation in the way of bhajan, can surely, same way who is following all strict rules and regulations in the way of his bhajan, can surely get the ability or quality someday to get tattva jnana. Ultimately they can get. After giving so much argument, now I like to speak one very important thing from Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapurana, 9th canto, 19th chapter, 14th sloka. Yesterday touched this sloka. Sometimes we think, if we can get enjoyment, if we enjoy material things, then we can feel satisfaction. But this is totally wrong. Enjoyment, your material enjoyment can never give you satisfaction. Your material enjoyment can never give you satisfaction. Because all sense organs and your bonded material mind always going to demand. They have demand. No satisfaction there. Yesterday I was speaking, touching this sloka. No jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. No jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. Havisha kishma vatmaivo bhuyo evabi vardhate. No jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati. Havisha kishma vatmaivo Batmarbo Bhuyo Evabi Vardhati. Just like fire is there, you are going to throw all ghee, kerosene, all inflammable object in fire. You cannot expect fire to go down. You cannot extinguish fire. Impossible. Fire can go on because you are adding fuel to fire. Mean you are giving enjoyment, you are going to give enjoyment to your sense organ. That means you are going to add fuel to fire. That's why you cannot expect. Na jatu kamaha. So by the enjoying mood, by enjoyment, we can never come to a saturation point. Na jatu kamaha kamanam upabhogena sammati havisha kismo bhattebo bhuyo evabi vardhati. Havisha kismo vatmaivo bhuyo evabi vardhati. It's not possible. If at all I am interested to get dibbo gyan, tattva gyan, if at all we are interested to grow our realization power, if at all we are interested to grow our realization power, to reach up to the point of self-realization, then surely we will have to take shelter unto the lotus feet of a bona fide spiritual master, pure Guru Vaishnava. No alternative. Even if you have taken shelter unto the lotus feet of a kapat guru, yesterday I told, you will have to leave that guru and accept, follow. You have taken shelter unto the lotus feet of a non-Vaishnav, externally Vaishnav based, but non-Vaishnav. Then you will have to leave that guru and you will have to approach Sadguru to take shelter. Otherwise, you cannot go out. Not so easy. I already told yesterday that Avaishnava Mukhopadishtam Mantrena Niram Bhajat. Those who are Avaishnava, not Vaishnava, perfect Vaishnava, if you are going to take mantra, then you can go to hell. Avaishnava Mukhopadishtam Mantrena. By the mantra, you are taking from a bonded soul, bonded guru, kapat. Then you will have to go to hell. In Shastra it is written, Avaishnava Mukhopadishtam Mantrena Nirayam Bhajat. You will have to go to hell. Then what to do? Punascha Vidhina Grahet Vaishnavad Guru. Again you will have to take shelter unto the lotus feet of a pure Guru Vaishnava. There is no alternative. Of course, if you are interested to come down to the level of a dirty, self-enjoying mood, like beast, then you need not follow me. You can take meat, fish, meat, wine, whatever you like, you can take. What I can do? If you like to come down to a beastly level, like a beast, if you like to come down, then you need not follow me. What you can do? Because you are free to follow your crazy, fanciful mind to take yourself down to hell forever. Even if you have some common sense, if you are not doing bhajan, even if you have common sense, still you cannot support, you cannot approve that kind of dirty food. That you think it's not possible. Yesterday I already told Tolstoy, Leo Tolstoy and other, you know, Pythagoras, all I told yesterday. If you have minimum common sense, you cannot approve that kind of bad association, bad food habit, nothing you can. By the association of a pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, you can change your whole life. It is written in Shastra, Krishna Bhakti Janmamul Hai Sadhu Sangha. The very root cause of Krishna Bhakti is Sadhu Sangha. Again, second line, it is written, Krishna Bhakti Janmamul Hai Sadhu Sangha. Krishna Prem Prapte Te Hoy Mukha. It is the very root cause of Krishna Bhakti. At the same time, to get Krishna Prem, to get Krishna Prem finally, it is the final thing, vital thing, without which you cannot get. You should understand the gravity of Sadhu Sangha. In the name of Sadhu Sangha, if you go on doing Asasanga mentally, physically, you cannot come out successful. Continuous Sadhu Sangha. Bhajan is not a matter of joke. Continuous Sadhu Sangha you need. Non-stop Sadhu Sangha. Mentally, physically, continuous. Then you can expect some improvement. By the association of pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, you can change your whole life to get bhakti and eternity. If you cannot do perfect Sadhu Sangha, then what to do? Now you will have to think twice before jumping into hell or fire. Now you will have to think twice before jumping into hell or fire to destroy yourself completely. Now you please try to think again and again that how I can say all the same. I can never say. I can never say all the same. How I can say? It's not possible. Actually, bonded soul, they are crazy, fanciful. They are dirty, crazy, fanciful, material mind. Always want to get some support or excuse on the basis of which they can do all dirty things. Sensual gratification. They want to get, they are watching one point of Harikatha. One point they can get, there Maharaj told it. So we are free, we can do. We can go for free, you know, enjoyment, sensual gratification. They are very clever. They are crazy, fanciful, dirty, material mind. Always want to get, always searching. They want to get some support or excuse on the basis of which they can do all rubbish. Free sexual enjoyment, free, you know, meat, fish, drink, wine. Even ethically strong people, what to speak about spiritual people? Even ethically strong people, they also cannot approve. Even ethically strong people, they cannot approve this one. What to speak about spiritual leader? What to speak about spiritual leader like Jesus Christ, this, that? How I can speak? How I can say? How you can say that he approved this? We cannot believe. I know. It is strictly prohibited. They are always trying to get some support, excuse, on the basis of which they can get sensual gratification. But they don't know that this way never they can get satisfaction. Saturation point is already there inside your heart. You will have to look back. You will have to look back inside your heart. You are looking outside. Prakriti Devi, material nature, Prakriti Devi, opening a big exhibition. And you are going to visit that exhibition. Some lucrative offers are there. You are going to jump into fire, enjoyment. But you don't know that this way never you can get satisfaction or saturation point. Sukham asti virakta samune rekanta jivina. Satisfaction, bliss already there inside your heart. You will have to look inside, not outside. Even if you try for infinity pure, still you cannot come out successful. You cannot get satisfaction. Because how you can extinguish fire if you go on throwing inflammable objectives like oil, butter, kerosene, ghee, adding fuel to fire? I already discussed this point. Na jatu kamaha kamanam upabhoge na sammati. Havisha krishno vatmaivo apmairvo bhuyo eva abhivardhate. This way. Srimad Bhagavatam, so you see, we can see another slope. Placidity of mind, it not possible to attain. You know, our enjoying mood can never give us satisfaction. If we can dedicate each and everything in the name of Rishikesh, Srila Bharati Maharaj used to speak very often, Rishikena Rishikesa Sevanam Bhakti Ruchyate. If we can dedicate everything, each and everything, in the name of Rishikesh Govinda, I mean Sadguru, if you do, automatically go to Govinda. If we can dedicate everything in the name of Rishikesh Govinda, I mean Sadguru, then and only then we can attain placidity of mind, transcendental bliss. Also, the next slope from Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, 9th canto, same 9th canto, Na jatu kamaha kamanam, this slope, after that another slope from same chapter, 9, 19 and 15. It is written, Jada na kurute bhavam sarva bhuteshu amangalam samo drishtes tada pungsaha sarvaha sukhamaya dishaha. Jada na kurute
bhavam sarva bhuteshu amangalam samo
drishtes tada pumshaha sarvaha sukhamayadishaha. When one can leave antagonism, when one can leave astigmatism or violence mood towards all jiva, non-violence, if we can accept this kind of principle of non-violence towards all jiva, then we can get satisfaction. Then we can get equal vision, because our last anger all coming for different kind of material desire. Kama esho, krodha esho, rajo guno samad bhavah. Kama esho, krodha esho, rajo guno samad bhavah. Mahasana mahabhavna vidhina menam bhairyam. In Gita Bhagavan speaking. Kam, krodh, lobh, these all enemies, your enemies outside. Then we can, when we can leave everything, all non, when we can follow non-violence principle for all jivas, even in Chaitanya Charitamrita is written, kai mano vakye kare udbeg na dibe, prani matre kare udbeg na dibe, in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Any prani, any jiva, you cannot kill. You have no right. So it is written, if you are going to follow this kind of full non-violence principle, if you are going to get equal vision mean in each and every body we can see Krishna, we can feel. When we can see in all jivas, Bhagavan is there, it's called equal sight, equal vision. Then we can get equal vision and then can feel all blissful all around. Equal vision mean equipoised or balanced darshan, having no partiality, no pain and pleasure mood, no profit and loss mood, no honor or dishonor mood, all same, beyond any profit and loss, beyond anything material. Friend and foe conception is not equal vision. We can see, like Uddhavji Maharaj can see Krishna inside the heart of Duryodhana. When Uddhavji Maharaj coming to meet with Duryodhana to find some amicable solution, peaceful solution, then first of all, Uddhavji Maharaj going to pay pranam. Pranam, honor to Duryodhana, who is wicked number one. Uddhavji Maharaj thinking, inside the heart of Duryodhana also Krishna is there. Actually, Uddhavji Maharaj is going to pay dandavat to Krishna inside the heart of Duryodhana. All my Harikatha is Srautabani. All my Harikatha is Srautabani. Vaikunthavani means Srautabani. I never speak anything of my own. All of my Harikatha is Srautabani. So each and every word and sentence has some gravity or inner meaning. Without kripa, you cannot realize fully. Also, there is every possibility to misunderstand me, because you can misuse Siddhantavani and try to explain wrong way. So please try to get enough kripa, mercy. So please try to get enough kipa, mercy, from Guru Vaishnava to realize Harikatha properly. Pure Guru Vaishnava always ready to bestow kipa on us, but due to lack of our sincerity, due to our lack of our sincerity and seva mood, also due to lack of our humble attitude, we cannot get kripa from them, from Guru Vaishnava. Useless dry argument cannot help us to attain the stage of self-realization. Useless dry argument cannot help us to attain the stage of self-realization. On the contrary, dry argument can throw us into the ocean of misery forever. Be careful. Please try to understand some following points, what I wanted to say through my Harikatha, when I was touching the most sensitive point of how Jesus Christ was killed. Please try to understand some of these following points I like to show. What I wanted to say through my Harikatha, when I was touching the most sensitive point of how Jesus Christ was killed. The way he was killed is very, very painful. The way he was killed is very, 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 very painful. But still, it is surprising that he was praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord for their mangal. I mean, those who are killing him, he was seeking mangal for them, for their mangal. He was praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord to excuse those killers. To excuse them. He was praying unto the lotus feet of Supreme Lord to excuse them for this kind of cruel activity. This is a big point which you cannot realize. This is a big point which you cannot realize. It is, here is one secret Vaishnava darshan, Vaishnava siddhanta. Simply I wanted to say that this kind of exclusive, simply I wanted to say that this kind of exclusive mood, simply I wanted to say that this kind of exclusive mood, this kind of exclusive, excusing mood, simply I wanted to say that this kind of exclusive, excusing mood, not possible. We cannot find this kind of exclusive, enduring power, this kind of exclusive tolerance is impossible. Or I would say, next to impossible. Which is really very, very rare, and only can be found in the life of a great Vaishnava, like Namacharya Haridas Thakur. This thing I wanted to say. This kind of exclusive enduring power, this kind of tolerance, exclusive tolerance is impossible, or I would say next to impossible, and which is really very, very rare and only can be found in the life of a great Vaishnava like Namacharya Haridas Thakur, who was beaten heavily at 22 different markets, who was beaten heavily at 22 different markets by the help of a strong whip, by those merciless Muslim policeman. By those merciless police, Muslim policemen engaged, they were engaged by the then, they were engaged to beat Haridas Thakur. They were engaged by the then king of Bengal, Hussain Shah, to kill him completely. Haridas Thakur was beaten heavily at 22 different markets of Kalna. By the help of strong whip, by those merciless Muslim policemen engaged by the then king of Bengal, Hussain Shah, to kill him completely. Srila Namacharya Haridas Thakur was also praying unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord for their mangal. Also he was praying unto the lotus feet of the Supreme Lord to excuse them. Prabhu, please excuse them. He was sowing the similar tree. I wanted to show this point. I was showing the similarity of both the case. You see, when Jesus Christ was killed, and when those merciless men, Muslim men, wanted to kill Haridas, I wanted to show the similarity, this point. I was showing the similarity of both the cases, nothing else. What kind of extreme exclusive tolerance? So though externally he was not at all Vaishnav, I know Jesus Christ was not Vaishnav. I know. But Vrindavan Das Thakur speaking, all infinity jivas, they are all Vaishnav. They confess or they don't confess, it matters little. They confess or they don't confess, it matters little. All jiva, Vrindavan Das Thakur Mahasaya, E. Chaitanya Bhagavat speaking, all jivas, they are Vaishnav, because they are coming from Vishnu. That's why Vishnu. Knowingly or unknowingly, we are all serving Vishnu. Maharaj, we are serving Maya. Maya mean Maya coming from Bhagavan. Maya also. Indirectly, we are serving Krishna. Material samsara, Maya, we are serving indirectly, not directly. So this way, each and everybody engage in the seva of Krishna, knowingly, unknowingly. Indirect seva, direct seva. Indirect seva is not expected. Bonded seva automatically doing. We never expect this kind of seva. You can also misuse this point. So, though externally he was not at all Vaishnava, but still the inside symptom, though externally Jesus Christ was not at all Vaishnava, but still the inside symptom showing his extreme Vaishnavism. Mahaprabhu speaking, Tenadu Visana Juna Tarurva Seshuna Amanina Manudim Kittanya Sadahuri. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Bhajan Rahasya, Brikho Jano Katilo Kichuna Boloi. A tree not going to ask any water, anything. Brikho Jano Katilo Kichuna Boloi. When we are going to cut a tree not going to fight with us. A tree not going to speak anything to us. Brikho Jano Katilo Na. Brikho Jano Katilo Kichuna Boloi. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing. Like tree Like trees, they are not going to speak anything when we are going to cut the tree. Bikkho jano katilo kichu na bolay, sukaiya moile kare pani na mangoy. When there is no water for a long time, that those trees suffering, but still not asking, give me some water. I am drying, give me some water, not speaking. Bhaktivinoda was speaking, Brikho jano katilo kichu na bolay, sukaiya moile kare pani na mangoy, jei ja mangoy ta dei apan dhan, ঘর্ম বৃষ্টি সহে আনের করে রক্ষণ. এনিথিং আ ম্যান গোয়িং টু টেক ফ্রম ট্রি, লিভ, ফ্রুটস, উড, এনিথিং, দ্য ট্রি নট গোয়িং টু সে, আই ক্যান নট গিভ, দ্য ট্রি নট নেভার গোয়িং টু স্পিক. বৃক্ষ যেন গাড়ি লোক, ইউ নো দিস ওয়ে এভরিথিং আ ট্রি গোয়িং টু গিভ টু আস. ভগবান শ্রীকৃষ্ণ স্পিকিং টু his friends in Vrindavan, oho esam varam janmo, their life is for the benefit of people. A tree, a river, their life is for the complete benefit of human, for our benefit. They never like to ask anything. Follow চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু স্পিকিং, দীনানাথ বিষ্ণু তরুর শেষনা আমানিন মানুদের কীর্তনীয় সাধা. লাইক ট্রি ফরমোস্ট উই মাস্ট বি মোর ফর বিয়ারিং দেন ট্রি. অ্যান্ড ভক্তিমন ঠাকুর রাইটিং ইন কীর্তন, বৃক্ষ যেন কাটিলেও কিছু না বলয়, শুকাইয়া মহিলা করে পানি না মাঙায়, যেই যা মাঙে তা দেয় আপন ধন, ঘর্ম বৃষ্টি সহায় করে রাখ. গোয়িং টু প্রোটেক্ট আস ফ্রম সানলাইট অ্যান্ড রেন, গিভিং অল in our fruits and flowers and leaves, everything, wood, and in return, not going to ask anything from us. I can give some example, through which you can understand what I wanted to. So though externally, he was not at all Vaishnava, but still, the inside symptom, showing his extreme Vaishnavism. Like Shankaracharya is full Vaishnav, but externally not Vaishnav, is preaching Mayavadi. We cannot follow Shankaracharya. Shankaracharya is Shankar. Shankaraha is Shaksha Shankaraha. But still we cannot follow Shankar, because Shankar is going to preach Mayavadi. But externally, Shankar Bhagavan also having tamasic, you know, dirty cloth, everything, skin, all body dirty, ass and everything. We are surely not going to follow Shankar. But surely we are going to follow his Vaishnav Adarsha. Guru Vaishnav, they know the secret adarsha of Shankar Bhagavan. Then we can follow our adarsha of Shankar Bhagavan, Bhagavan Shankar. But we cannot follow him directly. Like he is, you know, wearing, you know, skin, staying in crematorium ground, applying ash on all body, dirty. We cannot follow. Staying with all witch and a ghost. We cannot follow. Our Shankar is Vaishnava. Externally he is going to show, exhibit tamasic bhava. Internally he is sadasiv. We can follow sadasiv if Vishnu Tattva. Now what I wanted to say, that the symptom which was seen inside the heart of Jesus is not, you know, easy, not so easy, very nice. For some special purpose, he came. In this material world, in this form, to preach and establish Christianism. For some special purpose, he came in this material world in this form to preach and establish Christianism by the help of Bible, I mean the original Bible, not the Bible now compiled. Don't misunderstand me. What I mean to say, in original Bible, 100% I can say, there is nothing dirty thing. It was compiled after. 100%. There is so many countless cases, you know. I can give another example. Here in Santipur, there is one place. It's called Phulia. You know Phulia? Phulia is the place where Haridas Thakur used to do bhajan. Gufa. And our Namacharya Haridas Thakur used to do bhajan at the bank of Ganga in a cave. Haridas Thakur and our Santipur Nath, Advaita Gosai, used to give him prasadam daily. That Santipur, Phulia, there was one king long ago. There was one powerful king. That king was Sakta. Sakta, you know? Sakta, not Vaishnav, Sakta. So he was expressing jealousy about the things written in Ramayana. So he engaged one big writer. His name is Kittivas Ojha. In Bengal, he is very famous. He engaged one writer, Kittivas Ojha, to compile Ramayana freshly. Ramayana already compiled by Valmiki Muni. After that, according to the desire of Bhagavan, Tulsidas ji also compiled in a very sweet way, not in Sanskrit. Tulsidas was bound to, you know, publish, write. And Tulsidas ji, in previous life he was Valmiki Muni. Now this life, for common people, he is writing in a very sweet way, so that even village people can understand. Now, point is that king going to engage that big writer, Kittivas Ojha, to compile Ramayana freshly and to introduce some point which is totally prohibited. He is compiling that Ramchandra, while going to Rameshwaram, dirty people, they are making dirty meaning, you see, what to do. They are going to Rameshwaram. From there, Ramchandra want to cross the ocean and go to Lanka to kill Ravan. You know it. But that writer, that poet, going to write that Ramchandra finally, when he wanted to cross the ocean, he was bound to worship Durga. And going to offer flower, everything. This way they are compiling, wrong way. Ramchandra, Supreme Lord. And Durga is Shakti. Follow, you see. Ramchandra is Supreme Lord. Shakti is always under his control. If at all Ramchandra is going to be controlled by Shakti, that is a question of love. That is a rare thing, love. Aham bhakta paradhino, hi asatanta ivadijo. This is exclusive. Due to love, Krishna can be controlled by devotees. It is a separate thing. He is going to say, right, Ramchandra is going to worship Durga, 108 lotus flower going to offer each and every time. Durga going to show there is shortage of one lotus flower. Ultimately, Ramchandra going to throw an arrow in his own eyes to give, you know, lotus eyes unto lotus feet of Durga. He writing that way. There is countless, if I go on speaking such history, Prabhupada speaking, some unwanted people writing some kirtan, some unwanted people writing some kirtan and going to preach that kirtan in the name of Lochandas Thakur. Prabhupada speaking. Always and every time, so many writings there we can find in the name of Kavi Kalidas, very important material Kavi, very important. He got the Kripa of Saraswati. But big scholar, research, you know, they're speaking that writings of Kalidas has some speciality, what to speak. Some people writing and going to preach in the name of Kalidas, in the name of Vrindavandas Thakur Mahasaya. So many books and writings in the name of Vrindavandas. They are going, Vrindavandas Thakur gone, they are going to publish in the name of Vrindavandas. This has been that usual tendency of this material world to get some name and fame. They are doing some job. They like to get some patishtha for that. They are doing it. This way, so many, you know, even in original Quran, you cannot find on dirty things. After that, something somehow it was introduced by people. They are foolish. They are idiot. They don't know. They are foolish. They don't know. So you see, I was simply showing the similarity of both the cases of Haridas Thakur and Jesus. This way you see, for some special purpose, he came in this material world in this form to preach and establish Christianism. Establish and preach Christianism by the help of Bible, but original Bible. Now I can give documents from different source that Bible was compiled freshly. Some king was there, I can speak tomorrow. That wicked king wanted to introduce so many things. He wanted to prove Jesus Christ used to eat meat and fish and, you know, wine. Even those philosophers, big philosophers, Tolstoy, Aristotle, they are going to speak. Even ethically strong people, they cannot approve. How we can expect the spiritual leader Jesus Christ used to take? Eh? According to time and circumstances, it was possible. Like Shankaracharya, he is Shankar Bhagavan himself, but still came. Shankar Bhagavan came in the form of Shankaracharya to preach Mayavad, to establish Mayavad. But we know Shankaraha Sakshat Shankara. Though he was bound to establish Mayavad by the order of Supreme Lord, but still he is Vaishnav. But still I cannot follow Shankaracharya. But now he is going to express this kind of mood. Shankaracharya came to preach Mayavad, but still the external benefit we got. There were some, according to time and circumstances, it was very urgent. It was very urgent. So Shankaracharya came. Because that time, those Buddhists, they wanted to destroy all, you know, all our scripture, everything. Shankaracharya came, the powerful Acharya, Shankaracharya, he wanted to establish Mayavad. Still, he wanted to protect Veda. He was keeping Veda in front. Follow. First of all, Mayavad was preached by Shankaracharya, by the order of Supreme Lord. But at least he was keeping Veda, Vedanta in front. So this way, from the hand of Buddhist, he was going to save this Vedanta, everything Hindu, you know, culture he wanted to save. So, according to time and circumstances, were very urgent. So Shankaracharya came to protect Veda Vedanta. Pralaya payadi jale thito manasi vedam. You know, there it is written. I never told that Jesus Christ, I never told him as Shaktavish avatar. I never told him as Shaktavish avatar. Without the support of any scriptural evidence. I am not ready to say there is Shaktavish avatar without the support of any scriptural evidence. But surely, some special power was there in him, without which this kind of massive preaching would not have been possible. Now point is that, just like the coexistence, now tied to very important point, like to understand. Now my point is that, just like the coexistence of day and night is impossible. Or just like the coexistence of hot and cold impossible. Similarly, without exact Vaishnavism, that kind of extreme tolerance power is quite impossible. This kind of enduring power, this kind of excusing mood, this kind of exclusive excusing mood is impossible. That much I wanted to say. So surely, Vaishnavism, I mean non-violence, and non-Vaishnavism, violence. Jiva Hinsa, both at a time cannot exist. Surely, Vaishnavism and non-Vaishnavism, both at a time, cannot exist. Impossible. Shankaracharya acting. Shankaracharya actually Vaishnava. All his writings, everything, only Mayavadi preach. All other writing going to prove that he is Vaishnava. Now you will have to decide the point what I wanted to clarify. This is a simple logic. This is a very simple logic that if A is equal to B, if B is equal to C, if C is equal to D, then A must be equal to D. Follow what I say. If A is equal to B, if B is equal to C, if C is equal to D, then A must be equal to D. Simple logic. This way, I can prove 100% that surely he was never. This way, I can prove 100% that surely he was never in favor of approval of eating fish, meat, or wine, etc. It cannot say happen. This way, I can prove 100% that surely he was never in favor of the approval of eating fish, meat or wine, etc., all dirty things, which is strictly prohibited in the way of genuine humanism. I am not speaking about spiritualism, you know. All dirty things, which is strictly prohibited in the way of genuine humanism, even on the ground of humanism, we cannot approve. What do you mean to say? What do you mean to say? We know the teachings of Sriman Mahaprabhu. From the teachings of Sriman Mahaprabhu, Sikshastakam, Tinada Visuni Juno Tarurupi Sahishna, Amanino Manadur Kitanyo Sadavari. Mahaprabhu wanted to show. One must be humbler, one must be humbler than the blade of grass, more forbearing than the tolerance of power of tree, of a tree, must be ready to give away all honor and prestige to others to get the exact qualification of genuine singer of the transcendental qualities, feature, name, fame, etc. of Supreme Lord. Kirtaniya Sadahari. Bhagavan Naam, Bhagavan Gun, qualities, name, Rupa and beauty, all Leela, Dama, Parikar, etc. All transcendental. All transcendental, not material. So to sing all of his glories, name, fame, everything of Supreme Lord, one must have the quality. One must get the quality. One must get this kind of quality. One must get this kind of quality to sing the glories of transcendental Bhagavan, his name, fame, everything. One must be Trinadapi. One must be absolute Vaishnava. Otherwise, he cannot sing the glories of Supreme Lord. Only and only in a great, this kind of enduring power or tolerance can be available, can be found only and only in a great Vaishnava, nowhere else. Also, another evidence was quoted by Sriman Mahaprabhu in front of Sri Sanatan Goswami Pad. I am going to quote it from Sanatan Sikha, which is there in Chaitanya Charitamrita. Follow. And Mahaprabhu also was bound to quote this point from, Skanda Puran. Mahaprabhu quoted. I find it from Chaitanya Charitamrita, the teachings of Mahaprabhu in front of Sanatan, so I am speaking. Mahaprabhu was speaking about the non-violence mood. Mahaprabhu was speaking about the non-violence mood of a very cruel hunter. Mahaprabhu was giving example in front of Sanatan from Skanda Puran to clarify this point that this non-violence, also another evidence, from Skanda Puran, Mahaprabhu speaking, non-balanced mood of a very cruel hunter. After taking Mahaprabhu was going to prove from Skanda Puran that the non-balanced mood of a very cruel hunter after taking Harinam Diksha from Naraji Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj one day with going in the way of Ilhava Triveni, the confluence of three rivers, Ganga, Jamuna, Saraswati. Naraji Maharaj suddenly meet with one hunter who is very cruel. While Naraji Maharaj going to Triveni Sangam, Naraji Maharaj watching so many, you know, beast, they are half dead, lying on ground, half dead. Now finally Naraji Maharaj going, then one hunter shouting, "Hey, why you are coming this way?" Naraji Maharaj looking, "What happens? Why are you coming this way? What happens?" "Man, I was, you know, making one target. The target is missed target. Target is failed. You come this way. Oh, you are the man. You are killing so many, you know, beast." "Yes, I am killing." Naraji Maharaj speaking, "I want to beg one, I want to pray one thing in front of you. What do you need? You need tiger screen? You need tiger screen or deer screen? You come to my house." "No, no, no, no. I don't want any screen. Tiger screen, deer screen, I don't need. I want only one application I have." "What is that?" Whenever you are going to kill one beast, you must kill fully, not half dead. You leave those beasts half dead. You should not do it." "Oh, why? Eh? Why? What is concerned to you?" "No, actually, if you are going to kill fully, then it's okay. If you are going to make them half dead, they are feeling pain." "Oh, my father teach me. When they are feeling pain, I get enjoyment. I'm very laughing and dancing." "Oh, really? My father teach me. But it is my request, from today onward, whenever you are going to kill any beast, please kill fully, not half dead. Because you know, those beasts, they are going to kill you next life. Life after life, they are going to kill. You are killing so many beasts in your whole life, they are also going to kill you. You know it? Scriptural evidence are also there from Bhagavatam. From Bhagavatam also yesterday I told. Now you can go and take flesh, meat, and fish, and wine, whatever you like, you can do. Foolish number one. You can do. Now Naraji Maharaj speaking, "You will have to follow my request, you know." Naraji Maharaj speaking, "Life after life, they are also going to kill you." Then the hunter speaking, "Well, I have done so many sinful activities. How to get out of these sinful activities? Is there any way?" "Yes, there is way. You will have to break your bow and arrow." If I break my bow and arrow, what I can eat? This is my daily bread I am earning. No need. I can give everything. You go, break your bow and arrow, go and take bath in Ganga with your wife and come to me. I can give you Harinam. You sit in his place, make one nice heart with leaf and this and straw, and stay here. And prasadam, I can send all prasadam. I can send everything." Then according to the Naraji going to change the whole heart of this hunter. According to the advice of Naraji Maharaj, he is going to take bath in river, coming, Naraji Maharaj giving the Harinam and giving instruction, "You sit here, make one heart, very nice bhajan kutir, and do it." Another day, someday, Naraji Maharaj with Parvat Muni. Narad Muni together with Parvat Muni, coming same way. Then the hunter watching Gurudev coming, jumping out of the bhajan kutir to pay dandavat, but first of all, with his own cloth, going to clean the ground. Going to clean the ground before paying dandavat. And after that, paying dandavat. Parvatmini in front of Naraji Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj speaking to Parvatmuni, I have one disciple, very nice disciple. You like to see? Yes, here he is." Then Naraji Maharaj speaking, It is quite natural. Now, that hunter who previously used to kill thousands of beasts, now that same hunter cannot kill even an ant. Even a small ant cannot kill. Impossible. Because now he can realize each and every prani, all jiva, all prani, Bhagavan is there. He is getting equal sight. He can feel everywhere Bhagavan is there. I cannot give pain to any jiva. Impossible. And Naraji Maharaj speaking, you know, ete nahi adbhuta vyadha taba ahimsa dayo gunaha hari bhakto pravritta je na teshu parotapinaha. Chaitanya Charitamrita, middle part, 22 chapter, 62 sloka. Follow what I say. Naraji Maharaj speaking, ete nahi adbhuta vyadha taba तबा हिंसा दयो गुना एते नहि अद्भुता वेद तबा अहिंसा दयो गुना हरि भक्तो प्रवृत्ता जे न तेसु परतापिनः. व्हाट डू मीन? नारजी महाराज स्पीकिंग टू दैट हंटर, दैट वेधा हंटर, हो हंटर, दिस काइंड ऑफ नॉन वायलेंस मूड व्हिच इज सीन इन यू एट प्रेजेंट is not at all strange. It is quite natural. Ho hunter! Ho hunter! This kind of non-violence mood, which is seen in you at present, is not at all strange. This is quite natural. Because those who are engaged in Hari Bhajan, they can never give pain to others. They can never give pain to others. I can give so many examples, even from Bible, to Katya Siddhanta. Nobody can believe that Jesus Christ used to take. Nobody can believe Muhammad used to take meat. No. It is written already in original Quran. He used to take butter, honey, bread, fruits, everything. Jesus also. But they want to prove that he was cruel, he was doing inhuman activities, then how he is spiritual leader? How he can say spiritual leader? Police number one. You are going to prove it. I can give another example from Bible. And today I can stop. Tomorrow also I can speak about these topics. One day, one lady was very beautiful lady. Village man going to beat him heavily, throwing stone on him. In the meantime, Jesus Christ was passing to that place. And Jesus Christ running to that place and speaking, don't beat, why you are beating? Then those village men speaking, she is loose character, that's why beating. He is doing all sinful activities. Then Jesus Christ speaking, okay, you stop. Who among you are free of sinful activities? Can you prove that you have done no sinful activity in your life? I can allow him to beat that lady. Otherwise, you should not beat. Stop beating. From Bible. Another point I can speak. Really a spiritual leader. One small boy, very small boy. He cannot walk. Immature leg. Legs are immature, cannot move anywhere. Sitting in window and watching boys are playing. from window and laughing. Someday, Jesus Christ was passing through that class, and Jesus Christ watching that boy is very, very nice, and boy watching that game, sometime crying because he cannot move. Jesus Christ speaking, why you are crying? I cannot play. I have no ability to play there. Also I cannot see. I cannot see clearly they are playing because one hill, a very small hill, rock is there in front of my window. If the rock is clear, then I can see all they are playing. But I cannot. Then Jesus Christ speaking, you can pray to the Supreme Lord. Then Supreme Lord can move, can remove that obstacle, can remove that obstacle from you. You can pray? Really? Yes, you pray. You pray to Supreme Lord, oh Prabhu, please, you take away this rock from this place so that I can watch their game of those boys, small boys playing. I cannot watch. Jesus Christ speaking, you can pray. You can pray. Then the boy praying, oh Supreme Lord, please, you take away this rock from here so that I can watch the game. After that, watching the eyes and speaking to Jesus, I already pray, but the rock is not going away. Then Jesus Christ speaking, you are a small boy, I believe you. You speak 100%, don't speak lie. When you are praying in front of Supreme Lord, when you are praying to Supreme Lord, you are thinking inside that the rock, I am praying to Supreme Lord, but the rock, it is impossible, the rock cannot move. You are thinking about that? Yes, yes, yes. That's why rock not going. You are not speaking to Supreme Lord with full belief. You are expressing doubt, it is impossible, the rock cannot move. With this doubt you are praying, that's why rock is not. You see, I am praying. Then Jesus Christ is praying, and the rock gradually gone from that place. Our Rasikananda Prabhu, so many examples I like to give. Our Rasikananda Prabhu, he was speaking on rock, and brushing his tooth with neem, stick. And in the meantime, some Muslim, Sadat, he has some Siddhai. Siddha means Siddhi, yeah. That Muslim Siddha man is coming, riding on a tiger. He is sitting on tiger and coming. He wanted to show some excellency in front of Rasikananda Prabhu. And Rasikananda Prabhu, what he is doing, you can laugh, you can go and laugh, you can laugh. Rasikananda brushing his tooth with the help of stick, neem stick. When he is going to show this kind of siddhi, then Rasikananda Prabhu moving in front of him means with a wall means the rock as it is, Rasikananda spitting, sitting in rock, and the rock itself moving, the wall moving. So Siddhi, you say Siddhi, this kind of Siddhi can be there. So many Siddhi we know. Even with Mahaprabhu, some wicked man, they wanted to play a game, but they are getting punishment. So anyway, so many examples. Even I can speak the name of that king who wanted to compile Bible freshly. So that if I am going to open the skin of civilization, if I am going to open the skin so that you can see, you can get the facility of illicit sex, wine, then everybody can give vote. Common people, bonded soul, they want to get some support. They can say, this dharma, this Christian dharma is very good, but approval of meat and fish and sex, everything approved. Only I can go sometime to church and padri and get some indulgence paper. Foolish number one. Even common sense is not there. Foolish number one, even common sense is not there. They are going to lift up. They are going to lift up the screen of civilization. All inhuman activities. Inhuman activities going on. This is not civilization. They are going to approve. Then everybody can join Christianism. That's why they are going to approve. Naturally, men like to do all rubbish. Wine, you know, illicit sex. Wine, fish, meat. They like to take. Okay, they can take. And let me see. Let me see. Let me see what kind of improvement you have done. What kind of improvement you have done in your life by following this kind of dharma. Foolish number one. So this way, you know, whereas Mahaprabhu is going to give this example in front of Sanatana Gosai, in front of Sanatana Gosai, and quoting the sloka from Skanda Puran, here I already told, Naraji is speaking in front of that Vaidha hunter, cruel, cruel hunter, cruel. Ete nahi adbhuta Vaidho taba ahimsa dayo gunaha hari bhakto prabhitta je na te su parotapinaha. Ho hunter, this kind of non-violence mood which is now seen in you is not at all strange, not surprising. This is quite natural because those who are engaged in hari bhajan, they never give pain to others. So many examples I have given to you previous day, this kind of exclusive forbearing nature which is more than a tree, which is this kind of exclusive forbearing nature which is more than a tree. How we can expect in a man if he is non-Vaishnava? How possible that a man can have this kind of exclusive, you know, bearing power, tolerance power, except a Vaishnava? That is the main question. So surely he was in favor of non-violence. Surely he was in favor of non-violence. Surely he was not going to support meat, fish, wine. I cannot believe. You cannot prove. Old books, you know, you can find. Bonded souls always try to find some scope or excuse on the basis of which they can feel free. On the basis of which they can feel free to do all dirty activities like illicit sex or eating fish, meat and drinking wine, etc. All rubbish activities. What to do? I cannot fight with them. I can give some argument. If they have some brain at all, common sense, they can say, yes, Maharaj, you are right. Otherwise, they can go on fighting. Let them do. I never approve this kind of wrong activities. Never. Who is going to take undue advantage? I never speak like that. Don't speak like that. It's very... How you can get transcendental knowledge? How you can save yourself? That is the main question. You don't know. Your death is waiting behind. Everybody going to die. Any time you have to think over and again, then you can cut your enjoying mood. Try to get Vaishnava Sangha, Sadhu Sangha. Nobody can save you. Nobody can save you except pure Guru Vishnu. Nobody, no amount of your bank balance, no amount of your manpower, no amount of your educational power, nothing can save you. Kala karma guna adhino deho ayam pancha bhautikah katham anyangstu gopayet sarpagyasya jaya param. Kala karma guna adhino, you are driven by some unknown force according to your previous karma fall. If your submission is perfect, then you can go out of this unknown force. Anichannopi barseya baladiva niyajitah. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Arjun speaking in front of Krishna, that those jiva, they don't like to do any sinful activities, but as if some unknown force going to put pressure on them. Anichannopi barseya athokena prajuktayam. Try to understand this sloka from Gita. Athokena prajuktayam. Athokena prajuktayam. Papan charati purushaha. Anichannopi barseya baladi vanyajitaha. Arjuna asking to Krishna. Krishna, now I am asking, athokena, by whom? Which is the unknown force going to put them pressure, compel them to do all wrong activities, sinful activity? I like to know. Athokena prajuktayam papan charati purusha. Anichannavi, they don't like to do it. Originally, they don't like to do it, but they are bound to do it. How? What is that unknown force? Athokena prajuktayam papan charati purusha. Anichannavi barseyo baladi vanyajito. As if forcefully they are engaged by somebody, some unknown force. What is that force? Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to give answer. Kama esho krodha esho rajo guna samadbhavah mahasana mahapapna vidhinamenam bairinam. He is your enemy. Try to understand, Arjun, that is your enemy. Kama esho, krodha esho, that is your kama, krodha, kama, kama esho, krodha esho, rajoguna samadbhava. It is coming from rajoguna and is going to put you all in trouble, in the ocean of misery, going to throw you into the ocean of misery. You are so foolish, you cannot realize. Kama esho, krodha esho, rajoguna samadbhava, mahasano mahapapna vidhinam enam bairinam. This is your enemy. Try to understand, Arjun. Try to understand, your enemy is there inside your body, inside yourself. Your enemy, you are searching enemy outside, but enemy is there inside your body. Try to understand over and again. You try to understand. Tomorrow again I can give some more and more, you know, evidence in favor of my Siddhanta. I never speak all the same. I never speak people that you can do anything. I am so strict that even you cannot get simple, you know, approval. Simple thing. I cannot approve you. Very, very small thing I cannot approve. How I can approve this kind of dirty things? How I can approve? Try to remember, you are controlled by some unknown force. Kalo karma guna adhino deho ayam pancha bhautikah katham anyangstu gopayet sarpagyasya jayaparam. You are controlled by kal, karma, gun, material, modes of nature, you are controlled. Who can save you? How you can save yourself? There is no way. There is no alternative way. So try to understand this point. So, nocha indasya sukham, kinchinna sukham chakravartinaha, sukham asti viraktasya munir ekanta jivina. Nobody can feel bliss, placidity of mind. Nobody. Not even Indra. Not even Indra. Indra is not satisfied. Dissatisfaction there. Asar saṃsār khalu tukṣarūpī vimākah śutah kasya dhanam kasya snehobān jalate anīśam nācha indrasya sukham kinchinna sukham chakravartinah sukham asti viraktasya muner ekānt jīvinah vāñcha kalpaturvasya ke pāsindu vyavacha patitānam pāvana bhavishnavyo namo namah.